boy! Hey boy! This is the prep the day before the spring fling 2012. Let me put my finger over the mic so you can't hear me. Got my Weber Smoky Mountain right here. And I got a chimney full of charcoal. And I'm prepping this the day before. I'm not gonna light it today. And look down in here and you can see them briquettes that's normally covered up with foil. That's my water pan below that second grate. And I am a covered with foil, but I'm gonna do that in just a little bit. I wanted y'all to see that. And here's my Weber. And I'm gonna fire that chimney up tomorrow morning real early before we go grocery shopping. What's on your lens there, boy? Come off of that. And if the weather don't look too pretty today, but it don't matter. It, without the sun out, it'll be cooler. It'll be nice. Because I got a nice little patio right here. Hey, boy, see me in the window over there? And just smoke right up in that area. It's all underneath cover. That's about, I guess, 7 foot to the edge of the roof. All the way back. See that? See that? Edge of the roof. Something like that, 7 or 8 foot. So this be out the rain. And the rest of the party, let's go see. We'll walk back through the house here. My wife got the office set up in here because she's my secretary also. Means we finally got everything moved in today. It's still kind of pile up on pallets in the warehouse. But I got a big carport right out here. And this is where the big party of festivity gonna be. We're gonna set up them folding tables over there in the corner. And burl us some crawfish. You'll see. Crawfish burling supplies. Garlic, onion, salt, boil mix. Louisiana boil mix. Crawfish, shrimp, and crab ball, potatoes, got some mushrooms, some cauliflower, got some frozen corn on the cobs in there, and getting ready to make us a cheesecake banana pudding. Yum. Alright, so we got us a whisk. I got a bigger whisk, but I think that would be fine. We're going to make us a nanner pudding. This is Friday, the 30th of March. And we're going to do this and get it ready for tomorrow. And I got a bunch of bananas over there. A bunch. Figure it out for yourself. And some Jack's wafers. Look at Jack. Right there. And we're gonna start this. Alright, now some are you recording stupid? Good. Some of y'all wanted to see me in my chef hat. Look, it say JB on there somewhere. And it say JB on my apron. And it got beer holders in here. You can put pops in these little pockets. So the first thing we're gonna do is get Jack out of here. So we got some of Jack's vanilla wafers. And we're gonna put them down in there. Oh, so carefully. See there like that? Chunk some in there. Look at this big monster. Alright. I'm good with that. We'll put some in here. I got another bag of them, don't worry about it. Y'all get happy in there. Let me go slice up some bananas. I'm taking this hat off. I can't stand it. You wear it. Here. Now. Can you see me now, boy? Can you hear me now? Miss JB gonna help me over there cutting up some nanners for that nanner pudding. And I just opened up a fresh thing, a community coffee, cafe special, medium dark roast. Boy, it smells good. Ain't nothing like no Cajun community coffee. We're gonna go ahead and put three of these little tablespoon serviettes in there for 6 cups of water. Kind of like making rice, ain't it?
Always recruiting me into doing stuff for you.
You're getting recruited. There's another layer of ding-dings going in there. Now here's JB's banana. No, it ain't. Come on, boy. Y'all pay attention. Let's go ahead. We got a couple layers of this and that and what have you. Just dump some stuff on there. Now, save some cookies for me for later. What the hell? Use them all, JB. Don't hold back. You go over there, you go over there, you go over there. And you can go over there too. We got some cheesecake flavor. Fresh out the damn box. Some banana cream flavor. And two more cheesecake flavors. And we're gonna dump all that on there. Watch here.
That other night.
Alright, so we're gonna put some of the cheesecake pudding mix in there. And whisk it all around. How about that? This powder, boy. Some more of this cheesecake pudding mix in there. And then we got one banana cream pudding mix. I don't know if we're going to use that at all. I think we're going to put another cheesecake pudding mix in there. This is so good. All right, so we need about 6 cups of milk or a little bit less. It'll make it a little bit richer. There's 4 cups. Let's see what's left in here. Yeah, that's a little too much. There's another 2 cups. We ain't gonna use it all. I'll drink the rest. Whisk that up. 30 seconds, it's safe. You know I got a bigger whisk than this. It's down here. Bigger banana too. It is a bigger whisk. Wanna see the bigger banana? Now once you all happy with your whisking job, time to pour this on there. Well, I hope I got enough of that other pan. I may not. I think we can only do one pan. So there you go. That's how I'm looking. Amazing, huh? Now what I've done is stacked a couple cookies on there to keep this stretch wrap paper. I wish Miss JB was in here. It don't like to cooperate with me. Let me get her ass in here. Hold up. She's taking a nap. No union. All right, so we're going to try to put this on now. And that'll keep it somewhat off that custard. There's some on my finger. Let me cover the other half. Go stick it in the fridge. Till the flame tomorrow. That's good. This my friend Daryl, and he brought his other brother Daryl and Larry. And he's up from
Cincinnati, Ohio.
Come all the way down here for the spring fling, and he's been here before. Drove his motorcycle, and I'm sure it didn't cost him but about a nickel and 25 cents worth of gas.
I don't know, that $4 a gallon to kill me. It used to be about $60 on a trip like this. Now it's going to cost about $140.
Damn. And you know, gas going to go up to about $9 a gallon, too. Is what they're talking about. That's what it is in Europe right now.
Riding back on bicycle.
Hey, boys, the next morning, and we pretty hungover over here. No. We got us two butts. And get my gloves on here. There'll be some dead footage that'll have to be edited out. Put the fingers in the right hole, JB. Thing we're gonna do is wrench these butts, get the sand off of them and off feathers. But they ain't killing no germs. We got two kinds of rub. We're gonna put some wolf rub on one of them. Come out of there. I could muster them, but I ain't gonna worry about all that. We just pour this on there straight. Good boy, good boy. We got some of Darryl's original rub. We're gonna put on the other one. This rub smelled good. You can see it got some coffee in it. That'd be good to help with the hangover we'll have tomorrow morning. Why are you washing the gloves? I don't know. Why are you talking to yourself? That's what Cajuns do. Good boy. Alright. I did soak the wood this time. I don't know why. Hell with it. Wood in there. Get down in there. Water. Look, no water. What are you doing, JB? You gotta pour the fire in there. It's still early in the morning. You know what it is. Fire in the hole, huh? Now, let's try that again. Alright, which one to go on top? Bottom. Make it matters. Put it in there. That side. Up. You could fit them both on one grate, but... So what? Smoke, boy. Oh, we gotta get it some air. And I'm all choked off. Venus, I ain't got no Allen's beans. Come on. Oh, y'all go in there. Got most of them. And we're gonna dump a little bit of BBQ sauce on. Just just for general principles. I'll let these sit here and simmer on the low for a while.
Hello.
like that, Dutter? Get in there.
Don't he laugh?
We play pop.
Back in there, boy. Let this ball a couple minutes.
In there. See how small they are? This is pork skin. I need to get the oil cranked up on max. Gonna drop these in the oil and they're gonna puff up like a fool. And this is gonna keep them submerged under the oil.
Cause it'll pop up.
Yeah.
Well, that was sort of something.
I'm gonna stay under that oil.
Great boy.
Man, hammer.
Stupid camera.
Right,
and this Tango Joe, Tango Spice Company?
And why ain't you down here in Louisiana?
Boy.
Man, girl.
Girl. No, I probably went too long with these. I wasn't paying attention and the oil really wasn't hot enough.
Not paying attention. Pay attention. That's all on the week.
I ain't had that many pops yet. Heat up, Arm.
You eat that as a snack?
Yeah.
I guess so. I mean, Joe and Chris were just daring me to buy a pack and eat them, you know.
I haven't looked in the back.
Yeah.
Y'all keep it to yourself. Don't tell nobody else about it. So, here go the second batch with the oil really up to temp. Second batch draining. The oil temperature was up on this batch. So they fucked up more.
Yeah, they do look
a little bigger.
If they were a little, this first batch really good. Just control these quick. What this is actual pig skin. When they sell, when they sell pork belly, they cut the skin off of it, and that's what this is. Second batch.
It's already
coming out. A little bit of slap your mama, just pour them right on there like that. Let them cool for a minute and eat them.
Thigh meat is so much. It tastes good.
Oh, I do think so too.
Another batch. You just sit here and do this till you get tired.
That's very pretty.
You got the bone and the skin. You're frying. Well, if I did chicken breast, get the skin on all the bone and then you rub it off in the oven. But just that skinless, boneless chicken breast, all the chicken,
no,
the
meat,
it's terrible. Thighs, that's where
now,
it's at.
Thighs, thighs, I can take them, boneless, they're skinless.
Well, I'll use that in a jumbo lot, but it's only got enough fat in it.
Right.
But the breast,
but it is right. Well,
yeah, but I mean, that's the highest end price stuff you can get, too.
Yeah.
Don't tell nobody. I'm trying something else to spice it.
Darryl noticed he bought
Yeah, that one came out good.
Getting ready to come out, or as a matter of fact, it's draining. We fit to season them.
Yo, hey, help yourself.
Jordy put some on.
There you did.
I got season on. Is anybody else outside that didn't grab?
Yeah, really.
Well, that's about mama only, right?
That's it.
I like it.
Thank you very much.
I like it, Mom. That no problem. I eat a lot of that.
They're supposed to be submerged, and he made me this basket, and it. I mean, it's a preparated plate to try to hold them under that oil. And I kind of don't want to put any more in it. I hate to have it boil over.
Yeah. Yeah, good.
Them gloves sure do help, don't they, boy? Boy, you got something on your lens, don't you? You got to come off of that. No, it ain't. It was a stance, a spill.
Is that gonna be a video?
Damn right it was. It's still recording. This batch gonna be hotter, yeah, boy.
Yeah.
But we put another bag of bark bag.
A lot hotter, huh?
A bit. About one quarter hotter.
A bit.
All right, here's them black beauties. We're gonna try to get them off. And not have them fall apart, you're gonna pan for me and shit.
ball apart by beating the shit out of it.
Yeah.
You don't have to break, boy.
Samplers.
That must be the good stuff back there.
That's it, boy. That's good.
Come on. You camera one.
All right. Hold this one.
If there's a camera crew, hold this one.
There we go. You can get a side shot. Let me get this second out of here. Gloves don't want to fit the break too well. But I'm glad I got them on.
Wow.
Because I'd be burning my little finger off.
Listen to hear the sizzle.
Sir.
Give me some of that, boy.
Yep, sneak some of that in.
Hot.
Hot, hot, hot.
Ow! Burn myself.
Hot tooth gloves. That's how they fall apart down here.
And they do that way in Ohio.
They do the same in Ohio?
Yeah.
You can put this on there and just make good carnitas. Sample them while you got them.
Yeah.
Put the top back on there to keep the flies out.
Get it.
And that'll be good in just a little bit. Stop that. Cut, cut, camera boy.
Cut, boy.
Cut, cut, cut.
Ain't doing his job.
That's that baby apple.
Yeah. We all in trouble. We made enough noise. We won't hear all that crap. We just wrapped this up and we got it in there and we good with that now.
Go get your shoes on.
So now we got them all wrapped up in the cooler. Back side up, back side down. Daryl said,
back side up and the cooler.
It don't matter whether they're back side up, back side down, it'll cook and they're falling apart. Good boy.
Your basic,
crunch time.
Your basic, that's more legs, your
flank. Here we go. We got a butt that's just falling apart. Look at it when I pick it up. Just coming to pieces.
You pick from the back, quiet.
Who cares? Who cares? What? Look here. Look how it just mashes apart like that.
Oh, see that? When Matt lived it, that thing's huge.
But it is that one that's like a...
Look, watch this.
That's a good meat, check that out. I could do this. I'll film it being filmed.
Good job.
That's good. And the guy pulling it gets some of the best pieces too. Man, that's a good looking meat.
Grab your piece. Check it out. Am I supposed to shred this or just work it up like that?
Play with it?
Yeah.
Huh?
Just play with it, I guess.
There's a place down where you buy them online.
You just fall into pieces?
Yeah, it is.
Look. Clean bone. You see that?
Yeah. I don't know how to say it.
See how it come out?
That's what you said.
What he said.
I get it from?
Mashed pork. Now.
You
sure we cooked this long enough there?
I believe we did.
I think you cooked it to death.
It ain't moving no more.
It's full of juice. It's not dry.
Save that.
That is definitely not dry.
But still, even a sumo down from.
Try to strip some of the fat back. I don't know why. That's the best part.
Meatloaf, you look at it, it's a slice of bread. Like turkey and chicken stuff.
Yeah. So good. See the blackened ends? Look over there. Look over there, boy. See these blackened ends right there? Them man. And Daryl. And his other brother.
Larry.
I'll tell you what, well, I got them on.
But where we are, since it's so...
Go on.
I'll get that.
Go on.
Which one you want? There we go.
We snacking on this stuff.
That's nice bark there.
Oh, yeah. Look at him. I do want to thank everybody that came down and everybody that helped out with making the spring fling happen. And it was people that wasn't even here that sent in money to help sponsor the spring fling. And we'll do it again next year. One thing that wasn't shown in the video, several things that wasn't shown in the video or mentioned, was that after you're done with this, you've got to hose down the entire carport area from that spilt juice out of there, because it'll start stinking. It'll smell like dead fish, you know, the next day, because it's hot down here. This crawfish boiling burner down here, boy, is known as a jet burner. And it's a whole bunch of BTUs or Kelvins. And it doesn't even have a regulator. It's just got a needle valve on it. Let me just kind of zoom up on that needle valve right there. Okay. And this son of a bitch will blow and go. Let me show you how you light this thing. Now, once you got a big old pot on here and a fan blowing, you can't really depend on one of these little piss ant son of a bitches. You definitely don't want to use a cigarette lighter. So the way we lit it, and it wasn't shown in the video, was get you a torch, a little plumber's torch, one that won't blow out. Damn, JP, you turned it off too tight. You light this son of a bitch. Your BTU. Quick, fast, and in a damn hurry. Alright? I do want to send out a special thanks to Tango Joe of Tango Spice Company on YouTube, Half a Fish on YouTube, The Traveler, Ed on YouTube, The Traveler, his name is Ed, Daryl Sensi on YouTube, Renderer for the Rudolph Foods products, and we had a good time. We had a real good time. I also want to send out some thanks to the Blakes, all my family members too, and JP and everybody else that was here to help, because it was a big production to put on that much food, and we got leftovers. I'm gonna go eat some crackers, the gratins, right now. Ray and Noel and some others, that Jessica personal chef, and Moose. We missed y'all, boy. Wish y'all could have been here.